to my heart from Shannon Pierce. Can I hear somebody? And God, everybody that don't mean me no good. Oh God, help me up in here. Some of us still trying to drag folks along. And you know they don't talk about you. You know they don't lie to me. Some of us are weighted down with folks that are not attached to our season.
That's right. That's right.
When winter come in, you ain't wearing summer clothes.
Thank you, Lord.
Because
thank
you don't want to separate. I'm going to separate for you. Because what I'm about to do and where I am about to take you. Oh, God.
Jesus.
Listen, you can't take common-minded folks until spiritual stuff.
Oh, God.
I can't be showing them the people. I can't be showing them the one and the
okay. Look at somebody next to you and tell them, say,
neighbor.
What do you do?
What do you do?
When what's covering you?
When what's covering you?
Is jealous of you.
Is jealous of you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Jesus.
I felt the bombshell just come.
Jesus.
What do you do?
Jesus.
When what's covering you?
Jesus.
What's connected to you?
Hallelujah. My God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. It's jealous of you.
Jesus.
Y'all come stand in front of me. And just turn your face down.
You
gotta
let it go.
I hear the Lord saying, many have given birth. You're here tonight.
Yes.
You're giving birth to your dreams.
Uh-huh.
You're giving birth to the book. You're giving birth to ministry. Uh-huh. You're giving birth to businesses.
Yes.
And you're saying, God, but why is it, God, that I'm still stagnating, God? Why is it, God, that I'm not going anywhere, God? Why is it, God, that I still feel sick, God? What is it, God, I just, something is just not right.
Jesus.
I deliver, God.
Yes.
I see my baby.
Yes.
But God, what's happening?
Jesus.
God is saying,
God.
You deliver.
Jesus.
But you did cut the umbilical cord.
All right now.
Oh God, help me, Holy Ghost. He said, you delivered your baby. You delivered your purpose. Amen. But you did cut the umbilical cord. How many know the cord ain't no good once the baby come out? Can I help somebody up here? Remember, God, the umbilical cord. The umbilical cord is no longer.
Yes.
Any good.
No,
no, it's not.
No, it's not.
Service first.
When the baby come out.
Yes, come right. On.
Let it go.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen.
It serves.
Yes, yes.
There are people that are a part of our lives. That have came in our lives. We got to understand when it's time to cut the cord. What's going to happen? Why you still feeling sin and why things ain't feeling right? My God, look at somebody telling you don't got it. Good God.
Thank you.
No good. work issue.
Yes.
That's right.
My God.
That's Jesus. Right. Jesus.
One of the first things they do when they pull that baby out, they make sure it's going to cry or get a heart.
That's right. That's right.
That's right.
That's right. That's right.
And the next thing they do,
they cut
that
cord.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, they do.
Because it ain't on for me. If they ain't connected,
no good.
It's going to call something to either go for the baby or you.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
What am I saying? You got to learn how to let go. There are some people in this season that we got to cut off.
Yeah.
I told somebody if I cut you out, chances are you gave me the seal.
All right now.
But the umbilical cord is no longer
any good.
Yes.
What am I saying?
Yes.
There are some of you that God is promoting. Some of you have shifted and you still trying to bring old baggage into a new season.
Yeah. Gotta let it go.
And if we ain't careful, we gonna bring contaminated goods.
Jesus.
And if we ain't careful, you can move into a whole nother realm in God, a whole nother shift in God. But if you bring what is not connected and supposed to be attached, if we're not careful, mama, then it will infect a new thing.
Yes.
They said one day after the whole one. Look at somebody and tell them, leave it in there long enough.
Leave it in there long enough.
Jesus. Leave that bag up in that bunch.
It ain't all gonna run. All right now. Amen.
You gonna see food sliding.
Hey! Amen. Amen.
Come on.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's
right.
Guess what? Do it mean that the person is bad?
No.
It's time.
Guess what? They not bad, they just bad to you.
All right.
They not bad, they just bad for you.
Yes.
Come on, what are you saying?
Yes.
When they cut that cord,
they
got this thing now called stem cell.
Yeah.
So it's not good for this pregnancy no more, but that blood can help somebody else.
All right now. Yes.
Oh, God, help me out. So, you are recognize when it's time.
There you go.
When folks constantly frustrating you and constantly aggravating you, and you got to keep meshing, repeat.
Wow.
Oh, God.
It's an invitation. It's the demon.
Hey! Yes, it is.
We keep repeating cycles. We keep repeating cycles.
Amen.
Over and over. This man of God, that's how the wear us out. Amen. There's a God to pray him through.
Wow.
And then turn around and go back to the same stuff.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Amen. So you got to recognize that in this shift. And it's new season.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing God spoke and told me, he said, this is going to be a lonely one.
Oh, amen.
Many of you are wondering, God, well, why is it? It used to be a time you might have felt like, well, I need to be around this one. I need this one. And all of a sudden now, you don't mind being by yourself.
Amen.
Come on. So I God said, and he told me, he said, because I'm bringing you to a place of solitude.
Yeah.
I told my one of my oldest sons yesterday, I said, well, you know what you bring to the table, you ain't afraid to eat alone. Come on. Yeah. So what God is doing, he said, I'm bringing you to a place of solitude.
Yeah.
So what's happening?
Glory.
Folks thinking that you're acting strange, and it's not that you're acting strange. God has shifted you. So what used to be tolerable
is all right now.
Come on, ain't tolerable no more.
That's right.
Things that you used to put up with afford to stay on the same level mentally and emotionally.
That's right. That's right.
If you want a spiritual change,
you gotta share. That's right.
My God.
And something you're saying with God. Amen. We're rebuking the devil. Devil, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Let everything happen. I rebuke you, Satan. Devil, I bind you. Lose him, Satan. Come on. Y'all know what I'm telling you. God told me one day, he said, why are you rebuking Satan for what I'm doing?
All right, man. Jesus.
He said, why are you rebuking Satan for what I'm doing? I said, God, what do you mean? I know you ain't caused this. And he told me, what you still doing? He said, you still praying. You still fasting. Yeah. He said, the devil ain't going to send you through nothing going to make you fast and pray. Somebody say, checkmate. He's not going to put us through nothing. If you find yourself going through and you constantly praying and crying out to God, just begin to ask God, God, what is it? This is my mentality. Okay, God, what is it that you are about to take me? Or what is it that you're trying to show me? Come on. So the devil not going to make you pray.
No, he's not. No.
He's not going to make you pray.
No.
Because the Bible says that God is a reward. Of them that what? So you think the devil going to make you see God?
No.
No. Come on.
No, really.
So when you find yourself praying and you find yourself seeking God in the midst of your trials and your tests and your trouble, just begin to say, okay, God, what is it that you're taking me?
Jesus.
God, I don't understand what you're doing. But whatever you're doing, I can't do it on my own. I need you to help me. Come on.
Help me, Lord.
Amen. Listen, when they sent me home, woman of God, with the eggshell mattress, eating baby food out of the jar, told that I had cancer, told my husband that they did everything that they can do. I begin to pray, and I say, God, you did not afflict me with it.
Amen.
But I was constantly praying.
Yeah.
Constantly seeking God.
Yeah.
I didn't understand.
Yeah.
And God spoke and told me, he said, it's sickness. It's not unto death. He said, but that is a promotion. He said, I'm getting ready to shift you into another level. You know what I'm getting? I'm getting ready to take you to another dimension. Somebody shout yes up in here. When God is ready to shift you, listen. If you're going through the same stuff that you went through in 2016, 17, 18. And ain't nothing changed. Ain't nothing got harder.
Come on.
Whoa.
Yes, my God. Come on, woman of God. Please.
Look at somebody and tell them, check yourself before you wreck yourself. Listen, something got to get hard. Something else has to be added on. If you ain't going through something, either it's going to get harder. Stronger. Come on. Amen.
Come on.
This thing is real.
Some of us say,
God,
yeah.
Why me? God, why me? Why I'm constantly going through? Why this happening to me? Why this going? Why I'm going through this? God, why this test? Why this trial? Man of God, before you go, amen, just know that God, amen, sent you here tonight. Amen. And yes, there is a shift. God is doing the work. On the inside. Amen. I need you to do something for me. The gentleman over there, I want you to go and tell him, say, even in the midst of the trials and the hurts, God is about to drive the team.
It's almost 9 o'clock.
Okay.
God is even touching you in your body.
Get my
gonna pray.
Come on,
I got it.